On February the 24th, 2001, a one-year-old Canadian girl named Erica wandered out of her house and spent the entire night in the Edmonton winter. When her mother found Erica, she appeared to be totally frozen. Her legs were stiff, her body frozen, and all signs of life appeared to be gone. Erica was treated at a local children's hospital where she was resuscitated. To the amazement of all, there appeared to be no sign of brain damage, and the doctors gave Erica a clear prognosis. When a Christian backslides, his heart grows cold to the Lord, but God is able to restore that Christian back into full fellowship of God's family if he or she will repent. I want to speak to you for a few minutes on this subject. Good news for the backslider. Good news for the backslider. In the book of Hosea, chapter number 14, verse number 1, God says through the prophet Hosea about Israel, I will heal their backsliding. I will heal their backsliding. Israel as a nation had backslidden. They still belonged to God. They still were loved by God. They still had a future that God had promised to them. When Hosea wrote these words, Israel was in a backslidden condition. I want to say likewise, it is possible for a Christian to backslide. Simon Peter was a believer, but he certainly backslid when he denied the Lord Jesus and followed the Lord from a distance in Matthew 26, verse 58. John Mark was a believer and a missionary with the Apostle Paul, yet he backslid and returned home from the missionary journey in Acts 13, verse 13. The believers addressed in Hebrews chapter 2, verse number 1, were warned about drifting away, backsliding. In Revelation 2, verses 4 and 5, the church of Ephesus was rebuked by Jesus because they had backslid and left their first love. It is possible for a Christian to backslide, not to lose their salvation, but to break fellowship with the Heavenly Father. Now, I want to preach to you from Hebrews chapter 14 by presenting several factors about backsliding. Now, to those who have backslid to a spiritual condition where they're not as close to the Lord as they once was, I hope that the Holy Spirit will use this message to cause them, maybe to cause even you, to repent and be restored by God's forgiveness and grace today. First, the first factor we must consider is the desolate state of the backslider. The desolate state of the backslider. The term backsliding that is used in verse number 4 of Hosea 14 means to turn away from your relationship with God and God's authority over your life. It means to turn aside from the correct path to a sinful path. It means to become wayward and rebellious towards God and His will. It means to break fellowship with God. It means to turn back and engage in sin and idolatry. The nation of Israel in Hosea's day was in a terrible backslidden state. In Hosea chapter 4, verse 17, the Bible tells how that they had turned away from serving the living God and joined to idols. In Hosea 5, 9, the Bible declares how that Israel was going to be in a desolate state due to their spiritual choices. In Hosea 5, 11, the Bible explains how that they were in a burdened and broken condition because of their backsliding. In Hosea 7 verse 1, the Bible points out how that they had committed spiritual fraud because of their backsliding. In Hosea 10:1, the Bible reveals how that Israel was living selfishly, thinking not of God or anyone else. In Hosea 13 verse 1, the Bible tells how that Israel pridefully thought they were something when they were nothing. Really, the whole book of Hosea is a call from God to Israel, a backslidden people. Hosea's marriage to his unfaithful wife Gomer and all the suffering that she went through because of her unfaithfulness is a picture of Israel's relationship to God the Father and all of their unfaithfulness to Him. For the Christian, backsliding means that they are not connected to Christ as they should be. Jesus told His disciples and us in John 15 verses 4 through 8 to abide in Him just as the branches must abide in the vine. A believer abides in Christ as they remain in a state of constant fellowship with Jesus, where He can communicate His life in and through them and, as a result, grow spiritually, bear fruit, experience joy, and see prayers answered. When a believer fails to abide in Christ, remain in a state of constant fellowship with Christ, that believer will begin to backslide. When a believer backslides, there will be no spiritual growth, no joy, no prayers answered, a loss of love for other believers, a lack of spiritual strength to serve God, and an empty sense within from being disconnected to God. When a believer backslides, they will find themselves headed for a desolate state spiritually. Now that leads us to the second factor in our message about good news for the backslider, which is this, the direct invitation to the backslider. Not only the desolate state of the backslider, but the direct invitation from God to the backslider. Consider these words in Hosea 14, verses 1 through 3. O Israel, return to the Lord your God, for you have stumbled because of your iniquity. Take words with you and return to the Lord. Say to Him, take away all iniquity. Receive us graciously, for we will offer the sacrifices of our lips. Assyria shall not save us. We will not ride on horses, nor will we say any more to the work of our hands, you are our gods. For in you the fatherless finds mercy. In these verses here, God gives a direct invitation to Israel to return to Him. God invites these backslidden people to return. The word return here means to turn away from sin, turn away from idols, turn away from anything that you are trusting in other than the one true God. Not only does it mean to turn away, the word return also means to leave the location where you are and to come back. Make a linear motion back to a point previously departed from. Make a 180 degree turn in the spiritual direction that you're going and come back to God. Also in this invitation, God tells His people to confess their sin fully and honestly and sincerely. In other words, tell God what you have done. Tell God where you are. Tell God what you are going through as a result of your backsliding from Him. Furthermore, in this invitation, God is telling them to stop trusting in anything or anyone else. Trust in God alone to take care of you. Trust in God alone to save you. Trust in God alone for your protection. Now, just as God gave this direct invitation to Israel to return to Him from their backslidden condition, He gives us, you and I, today, an invitation to return to Him. I heard a preacher once tell how that several years ago, a mother had a teenage daughter who rebelled against her and ran away from home. The mother searched for several days, hoping to find her daughter and to bring her home. In a desperate state, the mother went to the social service office and asked for help in finding her daughter who had been missing for a couple of weeks. She explained how that she and her daughter had a broken relationship and how that her daughter had rebelled against her and how that her daughter, when she left, said she would never return. The mother finished by saying with a broken heart, "I love my daughter and I just want her to come back to me where she will be safe." The social service worker told the mother that she had an idea, but it was not going to be pleasant. The mother was willing to do anything, so the social worker told her, "I want you to go have your picture made. And then I want you to take that picture to the print shop. And I want you to have some posters made. And on that poster with the picture of yourself, you need to put your daughter's name. And on there say, 'Honey, I want you to come back home.' Then after the posters are printed, you need to go down to the brothels and the slum section of the city and stick those posters up everywhere. Post them in bars. Post them in the back alleys. Post them on light posts. Post them on doors everywhere." So the mother, in desperation to have her daughter return, did this. And within a few days, the daughter returned to her mother. And the mother forgave her, loved her, and restored her. Folks, God has done more for you and me than make a picture of Himself. God has done more for you and me than send us an invitation in the mail. He has sent His only begotten Son to die on the cross to pay for all of your sins. Those sins committed in the past before you were saved. Those sins even committed since you were saved. And those sins that you may even commit before you get to heaven. He gave you a direct invitation through His Son Jesus to return to Him. The same blood that cleansed you then is available today. The same mercy that pardoned you then is available today. The same grace that saved you then is available to restore you today. The same Father who accepted you then bids you to return to Him today. God invites you, dear friend, to return fully, completely, and immediately to Him today if you have backslid away from Him. With that said, we must now consider our third factor in this good news for the backslider, and that is the divine restoration for the believer. The divine restoration for the believer. Here in this chapter that we're looking at, God makes several promises to restore Israel if they will return to Him. Consider verses 4 and 5, which says, "I will heal their backsliding. I will love them freely. For my anger has turned away from him. I will be like the dew to Israel. He shall grow like the lily and lengthen his roots like Lebanon." Here, there is three "I will" promises. I will heal their backsliding. In other words, God is saying, "I will heal your soul that is sick from sin. I will bind you back up and restore you. I will bring you back to spiritual health again, where Christ's life can be experienced in your life fully again. I will love them freely." In that promise, God is saying, "I will open my heart of love and allow my great affection and care to flow out to you and to touch you once again. I'm going to love you voluntarily because it's my very nature. I'm going to show you my love for no other reason than simply because I want to. Then notice, I will be like the dew to Israel. Now you must understand, dear friend, that dew forms gently, and it does its work gently. Dew forms in the low valleys, and usually when it's dark. Here God is saying to the one who returns to Him, you may be in the dark. You may feel like you're without any comfort, but I'm going to water your parched and dry soul ever so gently and easily, right there where you are as you're returning back to me. God is saying, I'm going to water you with my dew to get you ready to grow in the sunshine of my grace again. In the latter part of verse number 5, God explains how that He will restore the people back to Him who returns to Him. He'll restore them by causing them to grow as a lily. When a believer lives in sin and is disconnected from the vine, the Lord Jesus, that life-giving one, that believer is not going to grow spiritually, and that believer is not going to bear fruit. But God promises to cause the believer who returns to Him to once again begin to grow. Then consider with me verses 6 and 7, which say, His branches shall spread, His beauty shall be like the olive tree, and His fragrance like Lebanon. Those who dwell under His shadow shall return. They shall be revived like grain and grow like a vine. Their scent shall be like the wine of a Lebanon. You know that a tree becomes more stable as it develops a better root system. Here God is saying to the believer that returns to Him, I'm going to restore you. I'm going to make you strong and stable so that next time the winds and storms of temptation comes your way, you'll be able to stand firm and strong and not give in. Then the word here explains how that the Lord makes the backslider who returns beautiful again. Now it's interesting in the verses that I've just read that the Lord uses an olive tree to describe and be as an example of beauty. It's said that the olive tree is one that is often gnarled and crooked, but its beauty, listen to this, lies in the fruit that it produces. When the olive tree is covered in beautiful and delicious olives, the beholder forgets all about the unsightliness of the trunk or the branches. Dear friend, our God is a divine potter, and He can restore and repurpose a marred vessel. Our God is a good shepherd who can restore and revive a sick and hurting sheep. Our God is a loving Father who can restore and receive rebellious prodigals who return back to Him. Our God is a forgiving Master who can restore and reuse disciples like Simon Peter, who disgrace and even deny the Lord's name. To the backslider, God is able to fully restore you where you are so that you can know His peace, joy, and love all over again. God is able to fully restore you where you'll be able to serve Him with gladness again and experience His grace and power once again in your life. Robert Robinson, author of the hymn, Come Thou Fount of Every Blessing, lost the happy communion with the Savior he had once enjoyed. In his latter years, he wandered into the byways of sin. As a result, he became deeply troubled in his spirit. Hoping to relieve his mind and heart, he decided to start traveling. In the course of his journeys, he became acquainted with a Christian woman. And one day in a conversation about biblical and Christian things, she asked him what he thought of a hymn she had just been reading. To his astonishment, he found out it to be his very own composition. He tried to evade the question, but she continued to press him for a response. Suddenly, he began to weep, and with tears streaming down his cheeks, he said, "I am the man who wrote that hymn many years ago. I'd give anything to experience the joy that I knew back then." Although greatly surprised, the Christian lady reassured him that the streams of mercy mentioned in this hymn still flowed today. Mr. Robinson was deeply touched, and by this conversation, he turned his wandering heart back to the Lord and was fully restored back into fellowship with his Heavenly Father. Yes, there is good news today for all backsliders. Return to the Lord today with all of your heart and watch Him restore your heart and life. May God bless you.